Hello, Southlands families. Glenn Duncan coming to you from our wonderful campus, specifically A3, my office. Boy, am I excited to be chatting with you via video. It's the best we can do for now, but this too shall pass. Soon we'll be able to do this face to face. I have some talking points I want to bring to you because I don't want to forget anything, so I've written it down. But let me just say this. First of all, I pray that you and your family are healthy, strong, and enjoying each other's company, and there's much grace on the home. I miss you guys. I got to be honest with you. I miss greeting the parents in the morning, the elementary students, the middle schoolers, the high schoolers saying good morning. I miss kickball, the Monday morning openings, and the way I deal with it is this. I'm just resting up because this too shall pass, and we'll be back together soon. I want to share something with you today at the outset. It involves a scripture because, you know, we are to be informed. Let me share it this way. I won't preach to you, but I just want to share something with you. So bear with me. We hear a lot of news. There's a lot of news out there. And just remember, the object of news is to get ratings. They get ratings by, yes, reporting, but in stirring up as much fear as possible. And I'm telling you this, I know this, if you're watching more news than you are reading the Word of God, you're going to be a basket case. So would I. So let's be informed. We're not denying anything. We're going to be informed. But you can go from informed, being informed, to being exhausted. And that's not what God wants for us. Let me just read a scripture of what he says about joy, peace, and hope. It's found in Romans chapter 15, verse 13, and this is the Passion Translation. I read this to you. I'm speaking life over you right now because the truth, Bible is truth, and it says of itself that the truth will set us free. It also says the Word of God is life unto us as we find it and medicine to all of our flesh. So I'm speaking the medicine of the Word to all of our wonderful families right now. It says this in Romans 15, 13, the Passion Translation. Now may God, the inspiration and fountain of hope, fill you to overflowing with uncontainable joy and perfect peace as you trust in Him. And may the power of the Holy Spirit continually surround your life with superabundance until you radiate with hope. I just want to encourage you, stay informed, yes, but stay in the Word, stay in prayer, get in your quiet time, lead your families in prayer, take time because God is the source of our hope, our joy, and our peace as we trust in Him. So be blessed by that. Let that be medicine to your soul. Because you know what? Nothing catches God by surprise. Nothing. Not your destiny in your life, the school. He's got you right in the palm of His hands. So experience that peace. I want to say something about our teachers and our school. Obviously, I lead the school and have for 16 years, but I am so proud of our Southlands team. I am so proud of our teachers, administration, principals, everybody. I'm so proud of them, how quickly they transition from being in the classroom to being in your home, doing online education. They haven't missed a beat. And you know what the neat thing is? They're excited to do that. They're excited that there's no interruption in serving you. And they're excited that there's no interruption to educating their students. And the other day, because we have people coming on campus, this one lady came in and she had some business to do in the office to see Stacy or Susan because they're here. There's about 20 of us on the campus still. And I was able to see her out my window and I got out my desk and I looked up and said, good morning. You know, I'm lonely here. I love greeting. So good morning. How are you doing? She said, doing great. I said, how are the kids? She says, they're doing fantastic. And she said this, I'm so proud of our school, the way you guys have handled this. And I'm telling you, encouragement is like oxygen to the soul. And I was so encouraged and blessed by that. And I shared that this morning. We had a devotion from 7:30 to 7:45 with all the teachers on Zoom. And they were blessed to hear that. We also have many inquiries, just for your information, we have many inquiries coming in from other schools and other parents that don't go to our school of saying, how did you do this so fast? Can we join in? And then we have a number of the schools that are just quite frankly just saying, can you help us? And obviously we're doing all that we can do, but our priority is to our Southlands families. Along with being proud of our teachers and staff, I am also proud of you, our Southlands families. You guys are great and you're winning. I know it's not easy. It might be the toughest thing you've ever done. You know, usually the word Zoom is something that you hear your little ones say as they're pushing a car across a carpet. Zoom. Now, Zoom has taken on a whole new meaning, hasn't it? And you're learning new things. But at the end of the day, you're doing it. You're winning. This too shall pass, and you will have passed the test. I guarantee you, in God, you will be better after this than you were before it. I'm trusting that for myself, and I believe it, and I believe it for all of us. And remember this, we're in this together. We here at Southlands are here for you. It is our privilege to serve you. And we want to keep communication high. I believe we've been doing that. I was so encouraged with the surveys that came back, so overwhelmingly praising how we've been doing this. And it's our heart's desire to communicate at a high level. So keep communicating with your teachers, principals, our office staff. We will continue to communicate with you. And on that note, you know this is a fluid situation, but if the government allows us to, California government, federal government, and if there is no danger whatsoever health-wise to our students, we're looking at around the May 1st returning to campus. And obviously, I am not in control of that, but I did tell you that I would communicate concerning a future date. That would be our goal. Let's see what happens between now and then. And so long as it's permitted to do so, and as long as there's not one speck of trouble that we can get in health-wise doing so, because your child's safety, your safety, everyone's safety is of utmost importance. It's number one to us. We're looking at around May 1st. But in the meantime, we will continue to do what we do. Continue. We, as I said, we're always available here for you. We delight in serving you and we're thankful for you. I want you to know that. So I encourage you to stay Southlands strong. Stay Southlands strong. And you know what? When I hear that Southlands strong, our strength comes from the Lord. The joy of the Lord is our strength. So when I say stay Southlands strong, none of us can do it without staying in His presence, as I've said before, in His Word. So stay Southlands strong. Enjoy next week vacation as much as you can, okay? And I pray you can do a lot of that. The following Monday, students, come ready, come back ready to learn. Come back ready to learn. Let me close with another scripture, if I may. It's found in Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. It says this, "They that wait upon the Lord, He will renew their strength. They shall mount up on wings as eagles. They shall run and not grow weary. They shall walk and not faint." As we wait upon the Lord, He will give us all that we need to get through this so-called crisis. It's not a crisis with God. He's got us in the palm of His hands as we seek and wait on Him. So God richly bless you, and I'll see you soon. Have a wonderful day.